Nowadays, a lot of information is modeled as digital streams. This data is formatted and standardized using computer languages such as XML, a markup language which has become a standard for data exchange. The size of an XML file can vary from a few hundred lines for a configuration file to several tens of gigabytes for a file describing a district of a city, for example. There are different standards, mainly published by the W3C, dedicated to each step of processing an XML document. For example, one of these standards describes the syntax and semantics of an XML pipeline, validation of the XML document, extracting information, and then output the results as an HTML file. An XML document is always modeled as a tree structure. Navigation within this document and information extraction is done using the XPath query language. Take the example of an XML document storing a bibliography. This document will contain tags like book, author, and title. Then one can formulate the query, find all the books authored by Mr. Smith. It can be expressed as an XPath query. Usually, the XML document is stored in main memory, and then the XPath query is evaluated. The first step is critical because the document may not fit in memory, and then the XPath query cannot be evaluated. Another approach is to linearize the tree in an XML stream, which means to read the tags one after the other so that there are less memory limitations. The challenge is to evaluate XPath queries reading the stream only once from left to right. QuiXPath, developed by Mostrare, a team of INRIA Lille, and by Innovimax, its industrial partner, evaluates XPath queries while reading the stream, without having to store the whole XML document in memory. To be efficient, QuiXPath evaluates queries storing only minimal information from the XML document. QuiXPath is early in selection and rejection. It minimizes the delay between reading a tag and outputting it. From a theoretical perspective, earliest selection is a piece-based complete problem. QuiXPath must also be compatible with the W3C standard and cover most uses. Finally, QuiXPath must be integrated into other tools that manipulate XML streams. Today, thanks to collaboration with Innovimax, QuiXPath is integrated into QuiXProc and QuiXSchematron. In the future, QuiXPath will be able to be integrated into an XSLT engine. We can extend this to a large number of streams so that QuiXPath can process information in parallel without storing each document in memory. Many applications in different fields are possible. Every day, banks exchange large XML data that summarize all transactions done in the day. Instead of storing each document sequentially in a powerful server, QuiXPath processes them in parallel with desktop PCs. This process can also be deployed to monitor many RSS streams in parallel, or to follow the updates of Wikipedia.